clearly outstripping their adversary. The French built a number of forts south of the Great Lakes and in the valley of the Ohio River. Hearing of this, the British dispatched Washington to that region. Washington was to deliver a letter demanding that the French leave the region and to thoroughly reconnoiter the enemy fortifications and their approaches. His mission was a failure, and in 1754, the British began building a fort at the junction where the Allegheny and the Monongahela form the Ohio River. But the French troops soon arrived and drove them out, completing the fortification and renaming it Fort Duquesne. In May, Fort Duquesne was manned by about 1,400 regular troops and militiamen. Additionally, most Native American tribes supported the French because they developed new territories and set up farms and towns only in the St. Lawrence Valley. The forts located in the region of the Great Lakes and the Ohio River Valley traded with the natives and neither oppressed nor destroyed their peaceful settlements. Washington realized that the presence of a British fort in that region would serve a major political purpose and could become a bridgehead for the troops. Shortly after, he attacked the escort of a French envoy carrying a letter which offered the British a truce, provided they refrain from invading the territories controlled by Fort Duquesne. This was one of the incidents which resulted in the Seven Years' War and in two decades of hostility to Washington's policy. The event brought forth indignation, first in Canada and later in France. Parisian newspapers called Washington a murderer and demanded vengeance.
Thank you. Thank you.